G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter here today. And what we're gonna do is have a quick look at doing the globe replacement and the annual service on this UV whole house filtration system, okay? Ultraviolet system. This one here is the UV that's got the double nuts on the end of them. So if that's the style you got, we'll go through and have a look at it, okay? I like to set these up and have them well installed onto the backing plate or the wall of the house or inside the shed or wherever it might be, and get them nice, keep them nice and dry. And on this end, especially where the electrical components are, we like to be looking after it and make sure that no water or any moisture is getting into here. We don't want it rusting up or anything like that. I also like to just come and service these once a year, do a good job, and that's it. As long as we haven't got any power fluctuations or anything messing around with it, these are very good, reliable systems. We should be able to just put it together and worry about it once a year, okay? And you do need to worry about it once a year because your health and the bacteria killing, etc., depends on it. And they do have some issues at times, depending on water quality, okay? So once a year, we'll have a look at it. And also, 9,000 hours is the expected lifespan of a UV globe. Obviously, the globe will stay lit after 9,000 hours, but they do lose their killing capacity and wear out, and they're not doing the same job, all right? So whenever you're doing the UV, make sure you allot a little bit of time for it, and same as we have done here, and we're just gonna slow down, nice and calm, and take our time with it. We don't want any breakages. There's no need for any breakages, but you have got to take it steady and be a bit organized, all right? So first thing we've done is turn off the power, pull the cord, it powers off, she's good and ready to go, and then we'll just start to disassemble it and we'll replace the parts inside as required, okay? So on mine here, first thing I normally do is undo the little nut holding the earth lead, and that's mainly the reason I do that is because this earth lead here is quite short and I don't want to break it. I don't want to hang the controller off it, etc. So I just take that one off and quickly just put our little nut back on, and then we're free running and ready to go. Okay, so steady, steady, off with the black sealing cap. Can use a screwdriver to lever it off if you have to, but this one will come. So we're just steady, steady, pulling him off there. Be aware that when you yank on that, there's nothing to fix it in, so our globe's coming out as well, okay? So there's our globe coming out now, the white part versus the blue for the electrical lead, and I'm just gonna pull that off there now, and we'll just put that off to the side and let him hang. With this part here, I'm looking inside. I've got to get a cloth, give it a wipe out. Is any cobwebs, spiders moved in, bugs, etc. We want them out. In the end there, give it a blow, make sure it's nice and clean, no moisture in there. If there is, clean it up. We want this to go for the whole year. Give it a clean, get it back to as close to new condition as you can, and then let's try and keep it that way, okay? So this is still looking very good, under the shelter obviously, but looking good. Now here's our globe, and we're just steady, steady. Every time I put anything in and out of these UVs, it's all at a very, very slow pace, all right? It just ensures your success, that you're not gonna have any troubles. So here's our globe, still intact. Had its lifespan up though, so it's worn out. We will put a new one in, but there she is there. Then we'll come along now. We've got nuts on either end on this model, so we've got to undo both of them, and then we will take the O-rings off and we'll pull the thimble out. So that one's undone here. And there. Okay, I'm getting to the end of the nuts, and I'm just taking it easy. Could be stuck on the O-ring. We just want to get that off. Beautiful, without any worries. But once again, end caps, clean them out, make sure the threads are nice and clean. Make sure the thread's on the end here. Bit of lubrication there, bit of grease would be good. when you lock them up, you know that they are locking up. You want everything to be nice and clean, so it locks up all the way. It does press onto these O-rings, all right? So there's our thimble there, and we can simply take the O-ring off the end. Now what I do is I push my finger on here with some pressure, and that's so I can bring it in and lower it down. There's a lip here on the end, and I want that glass to get down under the base here in one piece. So I'm holding both ends, a little bit of pressure on there, and I actually put my finger right inside, and I can lower that down under the ground by applying a bit of pressure from this end also. Once we're there, then we can just gently pull him out. Once again, as soon as it starts going, don't speed up. Just stay at the same slow speed. Sometimes you get them halfway out, and if you're on the wrong angle, they'll lock in place. So just steady, steady for the whole process with the glasses each way. And there we go. Success, no worries at all. Now, what can happen here, as you can see, this is just on rainwater here, clean rainwater, it hasn't been in for long, so there's no worries here. This is all still clean. But if you had bore water or something like that, this could be quite calcified, and it could be all white on the outside. Now that's an issue, because the globe on the inside has got to shine through this protective weatherproof glass and kill the bugs in the chamber. But if this glass is all dirty and covered in calcium, etc., from bore water, whatever it might be, iron from bore water, and it's all dirty, it's just a waste of time being turned on, because the globe's just getting hot and the water is not getting treated, because the globe can't, or the light from the globe can't penetrate through the glass into the chamber. So this has got to be clean. So if you've pulled this out today and it's really dirty, you're gonna have to take a look at it sooner, all right? Once a year won't be enough. So if I pulled this out today and it was covered in muck, then I know it's not killing the bugs. So I would put it all, clean it all up, get it good as new as I can. I'd put it back together and I'd pull it out in 1 month's time and have a look at it. If you pull it out in a month's time and it's dirty, well, that's how often you're gonna have to pull it out and clean it if you're gonna rely on UV, because this globe does need to be cleaned. Failing that, you pull it out in a month and it's still pretty clean, put it back, check it in 3 months. If it's okay then, no worries, we'll do it in 6. So maybe you'll be doing it twice a year if it gets real dirty or something like that, okay? Wouldn't expect it to be a weekly thing or anything like that. If that's the case, we better look at some better filtration before the UV system, all right? But there we go. We've got the thimble out, one O-ring here and another O-ring there. Now, for the price of an O-ring, I would change the O-rings every time. I don't want it leaking halfway through the year. I don't want to be messing around with it any time, okay? Short of the power going on and off or a power issue, blowing something up or something crazy, I don't want to be touching this thing. I put it into place, connect it up, and we're done. No need to do anything with it. It should just work perfectly. Keep it dry and you're good to go, okay? Okay. Now, we got him all down. She's all looking good. Get a cloth, give it a clean up, make sure our threads are lubricated, the nuts are good to go, everything's happy, and we're happy and it's nice and clean, and then we're gonna put him back together, okay? So first thing we're gonna do is generally put some gloves on, okay? When you're putting these globes and thimbles or quartz sleeves back in, we don't wanna get our oily fingers all over and put marks all over them, okay? We wanna keep them crystal clear. Clean as they can be is the better, okay? So I'll generally get some gloves on, get a little bit of methylated spirits, and just get a normal tissue, bit of metho. And we get out of our thimble, and we'll give him a clean, okay? Just a wipe up and down. Now this is gonna depend how dirty this thimble is, all right? If this thimble is had rainwater on it, and it's nice and clean like that, you see, we give it a wipe, and it's beautiful, crystal clear and clean, we're good to go. And this will last for years, okay? Just keep cleaning it, no worries at all. If you got bore water, real harsh bore water even, might even be pitting the glass with the heat and the bore water depending on how harsh it is. So sometimes you'll need to replace the thimble with the globe if you can't clean it, all right? So the moral of the story is this thimble has got to be clean, all right? So there we go, he's nice and clean. As soon as he's clean, all we can do is slide him back in. Once again, snail's pace. Everything's done at a snail's pace when we're playing with these electrical components and the glassware especially, okay? Once you get him in there, you'll feel it goes in on an angle. I can feel it about here, hitting on the bottom of the chamber. We're just gonna slide him through and you'll get to the end. I'm going to put my finger in here, right? I'll just show you. I'll put my finger in, and I'm going to put it in as far as it'll go, and that thimble now is sitting about here. I'm going to put my finger in and put it on the end of the thimble, apply a bit of pressure from that end, so then I've got the thimble sitting vertical, or horizontal, sorry. Then I've got it sitting horizontal, straight through the middle of this housing, and I can just pick it up and pull it straight out the end here, right? Very successful way of doing it. Rather than getting here and trying to push it up and down and trying to work your way and find that hole, okay? Just slow it down. I can feel the thimble. I've got my finger in the center of the thimble. I'm gonna apply a bit of pressure here on this right hand end, and I can just lift him up and bring it out, sweet as apples, all right? That's the go. Okay. Once we've done that, we've got a couple of O-rings, and as I said, for the price of a couple of O-rings, it's good to put a couple of newies on. They'll go a couple of years though. It just depends on the conditions, the heat, where you're situated, obviously, but these are all looking okay. So we'll put our O-rings on. As you can see, and you would have noticed this if you've been using it or had it in for 12 months, you've got a bit of the glass sticking out on each end, okay? So we get our O-ring, and just slide the O-ring straight on the end. I do note that it slides on a lot easier if it's got a little bit of lube on there, and that's perfect fit. We just got him sticking out the end there, that bell a bit, all right? This one here. Okay. Just spinning the O-ring, getting the O-ring up against the thread, put the O-ring right on the thread there, and the glass is equal on each end. Okay. We set it set up there, perfect, ready to go. These O-rings here are good, nice round O-rings. Sometimes you get an O-ring that's rounded on the outside, but it's got a flat on the internal. When you got those types of O-rings, you can't roll them on because they can twist and they just won't seal on the face here. So make sure if you've got a flat O-ring that you do put a bit of lube on it so that it can slide in there. The flat stays against the glass and the rounded is on the outside, all right? But as you can see, we're laughing today. It's all going together very nicely. Now we're going to put our caps back on. Obviously the cap with the closed end is on the bell end or the opposite end to where you're putting your controller. And we'll put the open end here on the end where our controller's going to go. Okay. Start screwing those up. Feel it starting to get firm here now. So to stop this one for a second. Take the right hand up till it's starting a bit firm, and then I'm doing it up together. I'll get this one up tightest first. Lock him on tight as I can, up to this end. Lock him on as tight as we can, okay? I can see in there, I can see that the O-ring is nicely sealed around that end, and we're good to go, all right? So that was a success, we're having a win, whoop, okay. Then, once we get done that one, I'll just keep my gloves on for a second, and we will give the lamp a bit of a wipe over as well. Now the lamp's new, the thimble might not have been new, we're just giving it a clean, and we'll use whatever we need to do to clean it. Might even be a scourer of some description, depending what's on the outside and depending on the water quality. So here's the thimble, the globe. Globe's done 1 year, 9,000 hours. You get a new globe and could have a little bit of oil and stuff on the outside of it from the manufacturing. And we're just gonna give that baby a little light wipe over. Make sure it's all nice and clean as well. We want everything as clean as we can, almost sterile. Looking good, okay? Once again, at a snail's pace, we're just gonna gently slide that globe straight through the UV. Magnificent, okay, and that'll do me there. Then we're just basically putting this baby back together, and I'll put the electrical connection onto the globe first, and we'll gently get that inside. We'll get this rubber on to seal, keep as much weather out as we can. Beautiful, And then we've also got this one here. Another reason I don't I take this little electrical lead off is if you leave the electrical lead on and you are able to get the rubber cover off the end, and then you undo the globe from the lead, then the electrical component's going to be hanging, all right? Now this little wire will support the weight of the electrical lead, etc. But while you're doing it, if it's down in the ground and you stand on it, or you hook it on the lamp or the thimble or something, all of a sudden you give it a pull, you're liable to just pull the earth lead straight off the end. So I'll just be a bit gentle and careful with everything we're doing here, and it just makes sense to quickly pull him off for an extra minute, okay? Going on there, bend him down. Little crescent here to tighten him up. Beautiful, there we go. It's on there, double checking, make sure that our seal's on. Don't want any water in here. Whatever happens, gotta be covered, gotta be kept dry. Electrical components, that's the story, all right? There we go. As you can see, she's all put back together. Better note, I think I might have missed that one for you. Once I put that thimble in, I turn the water on, okay? I jumped the gun a bit there and I slid the lamp inside the thimble, but normally once I put the thimble in and I tighten the nuts up, I would turn the water on and I'd make sure that this was right up to pressure with the water on. Once I've got no leaks, then I'll come back, slide my lamp in and put the electrical components on, and now we're good to go, okay? So it's vitally important that it's sealed, the thimble's installed, the end nuts are put on tight, you turn your water on and off and you check that there's no leaks and it's sealed. Once you're happy that you've got a reseal on it, then we'll grab the lamp, slide the lamp in, put on the connection for the lead, tighten up the earth, and here we are now here ready to go. So we can just get the cord, plow it in. I heard it beep and our green lights come on and we're good to go. If it wasn't, we'd be seeing a red light, and this one has an alarm on it as well, and it would be sounding. So if the alarm's sounding or the red light's on, the lamp isn't working, something's wrong, okay? But that's it folks, pretty easy. Do it right, look after it, keep it out the weather, take care of it. You only have to touch it once a year to put a new globe in and you'll be good as gold. Have a look on the site, anything we can help you with, give us a call, love to hear from you, and thank you very much.